Hey guys, very quick video. As you can see on the screen, I have a bunch of the update notes, which I will be going on in a second. But if you saw the time thumbnail or anything, you know this is about the update. So I'm not going to waste any time. Make sure to like and subscribe to support the channel. Helps me out a ton. But not to waste any time, this is when the update will be. The update will be on the 9th. So 7 days from now, as of now. Obviously, you could see that the time it's going to last about 2 hours, where we won't be able to log on because the update will be happening, and then we'll be able to log on. You could see the time on the screen. If you want to like convert it to your time, you could use a website or something. Doesn't really matter. We'll be getting 100 diamonds, but we also remember got that 10 pole, 2 ancients, skill crystals, stuff like that as part of compensation. So this is not the only compensation that we've gotten. So keep that in mind. I think decent. Reward for it, and we actually have a date now, which is sick. This will be announced pretty soon, so thank you to Rokanchi for leaking it early. Now, let's go over the changes, shall we? So, the Guild War is season rewards upgraded from Platinum 1 and above, which is like the top 50% or something, maybe less actually, but it's the top of Guild in a way, and above ranks will receive the new season exclusive emote. So you will be able to get emotes, and then they're adding something called the Gladiator's Gauntlet, which essentially is like a 32-person fight in a way where, I mean, we could go down here and skip a bit. Gladiator's Gauntlet's going to be launched starting from season 5, so the season after this one, and the top ranked guilds in Guild V Guild or Guild War will qualify for it. And then they're going to go through a single elimination format, and Mad Elite is going to win the end, and that's going to be fun. So that's for Overlord guilds. But yeah, so you will also be able to get Mind Marauder Greed, which, if I have time, I'll put on the screen. It's from a very long time ago. You get a guild pattern and more rewards. The map changes have been changed. I will put those on the screen as well. And in season 5, Central Keep will be using the tower defense map that we have right now. So Ingrid will be oppressive as hell in keeps, but at least not every team will have like 30 keeps or whatever. They only have 4. And then the defense tower is going to have a brand new one. Now, we are also getting a new epic demon soldier. You could check out Sebastian's video, has a great one. Pretty sure Quaz has made a good one on it. There's probably some other creators, so sorry to you guys who I'm not mentioning. There's a lot of good Forerunner creators that you could check out. You also get more rewards and better interface. Now, the raids are also going to be increase the XP gained by a single hero when clearing gear raid and promotion raid, so that'll be interesting. We're going to also have optimized drops of promotion raid extreme stages. So instead of 5, you're going to get 7. And instead of increase from 5 to 7, 5 to 10 on extreme. My brain is having a stroke. So extreme 1 is 5 to 7, and extreme 2 is 5 to 10. So extreme 2 is going to be by far the best, no matter where you are. We're going to all have like 1,000 of the other ones because you get. All three types, and we're obviously all going for the legendary ones, but it's still good. Like a guaranteed 10 is insane, and we'll make that by far the easiest to farm. So shout out to the devs for actually listening on that, because that pissed me off. We're also going to get better rewards and high difficulty chests in Guild Boss 2. Removed mythic extract and legendary extract from the chest rewards in Nightmare 3 and 4. Sick. I have like 200 mythic extract. And then we're also getting optimized rewards from the daily free offer. So you get a chance to gain permits. And also, they removed the gold, so they basically replaced it. And then, these things you could look, right? Who cares? Now, that is pretty much all the changes. Like I said before, it's going to be from the 9th. And that's sick. So then we'll finally be able to get the updates. And I'm sure that the last update stuff will also be added. I think there was some update stuff, like with the gearing system or whatever, that will probably also be added. I assume this is just additional stuff. I could be wrong. And this date might not be 100% correct, but it is what is displayed in some leaked and future announcements. So when we get those, it will confirm the date, but it seems for now the best guess, and even just the confirmed guess, is the 9th. So that's pretty hype. Very excited for that. Will allow us to start getting future updates as well, 100%. hopefully there's no issues in the future and we continue to have frequent updates, unlike what just happened. I know it's a big deal, so that's great. So thank you guys for watching. I do appreciate it. Little sorry if the audio is a bit weird. I just got a new laptop and I haven't fully set up the OBS yet, so if it peaks at all or anything, I'm really sorry. I will get that fixed, and I'll actually be able to stream some games. Maybe I'll make a Twitch account. I don't really know. But yeah, so like and subscribe if you would like, and Destin signing up.